Our seventh question says that Rohan, who has aged 22 and he saw a birthday offer outside a shop.
Okay.
The offer includes a discount of DA% on the payable amount if the customer has birthday on that particular day.
Okay.
Where A is the age of the customer and the DA is a function. And DA is given like this. The shop also has a Sunday offer, which is flat discount of 1500 if the initial purchase amount is more than 12,000.
Okay.
Suppose Rohan has a friend whose age is 25 who shares the same birthday with Rohan on a particular Sunday. So Sunday and both the friends have the birthday on that Sunday also. Express the final payable amount as a function in terms of A and find the possible minimum amount needed to be paid if Rohan purchased some commodities of 15,000 from the shop. It is also given that A&A offer can be applied first and Rohan can use his birthday or his friend's birthday for the offer.
Okay.
So let's try to understand what the question is. So question is about Rohan whose age is 22 and his friend whose age is 25. Rohan wants to use any of them the birthday.
Okay.
And the shop has offered two offers. Offer one is the discount of DA%.
Okay.
So how will I apply offer one? It means if the payable amount or purchase amount is M, then the DA% discount you will get on purchasing.
Okay.
So this is how we write the discount when the percent discount is given.
Okay.
So this is actually discount. So offer one is a discount. What is offer two? Offer two is a Sunday offer. Sunday offer, which means if the purchase amount is less more than 12,000, so in that case the discount is 1500. So offer two is the discount of 1500. Okay. So this is the offer two. The payable amount after applying first offer. First offer means individual first offer. Only first offer if I apply, that is birthday offer. The payable amount will be the initially payable amount, whatever the payable amount is or purchase amount, minus the discount. And discount is what? That PM will be replaced by P because P is the payable amount. So DA divided by 100. And if you solve this, you will get P 100 minus D of A divided by 100. So this is the offer one. This is the payable amount if we apply the first offer. Now, what is the second offer? Second offer is saying if the amount payable is this, then reduce 1500. This will be the payable amount P2. So here the payable amount will be whatever the you purchase, that is 15,000. Or I can say if I apply 15,000 here, so minus 1500. So if I apply P2 directly, so I'll get this much amount. If P is the payable amount rather than 1500, not in general case, so this will be 1500. Don't get confused with this P and this P. Okay. So these are two different cases. Now the question, let's try to understand the question. There is a different scenarios. So in case one, this is the purchase amount, which can I say P. Okay. Then apply the first offer, which is the birthday offer. I'll get some P1. Okay. Then apply the second offer, which is Sunday offer, I'll get some P12. Okay. Then there will be two cases, which A equal to 22 or A equal to 25 should we use. So for minimum payable amount, this will be the case for case one when we go with this process. What is the case two? P, the purchase amount, minus Sunday offer, which is second offer, but I will write Sunday offer, which means this will be P1 and this will be P2 because we are getting the Sunday offer first. So P2, and then this will be P21 if I apply the birthday offer, which is the first offer, birthday offer. Okay, then again I'll have to decide what should I take, A equal to 22, his birthday or his friend birthday equal to 25. These are the two cases I need to think about. So should we work on first case one? Case one is a P. So P is 15,000. Okay. What is the birthday offer? That discount of some percentage amount. And that is P1 actually. So P1 is equal to P1 100 minus D of A. We calculated this 100. So this is P1. Okay. What will be P12? P12 is equal to reduce from here to here to get P12. So P1 minus 1500. This is P12. So P12 is equal to P1 is P 100 minus D of A divided by 100 minus 1500. Okay. So what is P? P is given 15,000. 100 minus D of A, 100 minus 150. Take 150 common, then you will get 100 minus D of A minus 10. This is the final payable amount for the case when we apply first offer first and then second offer second. Now we need to choose what should be the A and what will be the minimum possible amount. For that purpose, I need to write A here. And A, DA is minus A square plus 50A minus 600. So 150, 100 minus A square plus 50A minus 600 minus 10. Okay, so 150, it will be 100 plus E square minus 50A plus 600 minus 10. So P12 is actually 150, 600, 700 minus 10. So A square minus 50A, 600 in plus 700 minus 10 is will be 690 plus 690. Okay. Now you can understand this P12 is a quadratic function, and for possible minimum amount, we need to find the vertex as we did in week 4. So I'll directly find the vertex. So A will be for minimum possible amount, paying minimum possible amount, minus B, which will be minus of minus 50 divided by 2A means 2. So it will be 25. So A equal to 25 means Rohan should use his friend's birthday for the purchasing so that he can get, he will have to pay minimum amount. Okay. Now what will be P12 when A is equal to 25, so put A equal to 25, I'll get 150, 25 square minus 50A plus 690. So the after calculation, the payable amount for P12 will be 9750. What if we apply the second case? First Sunday offer, then the birthday offer. Okay, so I'll do it very fast as we have discussed the first case. So for case two, the P2 will be P minus 1500. So P is 150,000 minus 1500. Okay, it will be 13,500. So P2 is 13,500. Now P1 P21 will be applied on the P2 and the discount will take 100 minus D of A divided by 100 and that will be 13,500 minus D of A divided by 100. So it is 1,3500 minus if I replace DA with the function, so it will be A square minus 50 A plus 600. Okay, so I'll get 135 A square minus 50 A plus 700. Now again we will follow the same procedure that minimum amount will be on A equal to minus B by 2 and again A is equal to 25 we are getting. So he should use his friend's birthday for the second case also. What will be the minimum payable amount in this case? 135 A square means 25 square minus 50 into 25 plus 700. Okay. So after solving this, we'll get P21 is equal to 10,125. Okay. So obviously, P12, which was around 9,000, we solved here. 9,750. And P21 is 10,125. Okay. So clearly, this is the list amount to be paid. So the answer for this question will be what? A should equal to 25, which means Rohan should use his birthday, his friend's birthday, and the payable amount will be 9,750 when he uses the birthday offer first and then the Sunday offer. So this is the answer.